Hey there guys, how's it going? My name is The Broken Machine, and in today's gameplay, I'm going to be showcasing you a gameplay where I managed to take down 5 helis with a straw in a single round. This is a 22-1 gameplay, it is on Gulf of Oman, and it is on Rush Defense. So, let's start off this gameplay. What I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to be trying to intercept the heli, the enemy's heli, straight off the spawn with the straw rockets. So I'm making my way up here, having a look if I can see one. Can't see one, so I'm going to carry on. And here we go. I managed to see it right there, but I'm going to just move over a little bit. And what you'll see here is I shoot to the right and then bring it in towards the left. And that's probably one of the best tactics I would recommend with using the straw rockets. Try and aim it ahead of its path and then bring it in. You'll notice on this shot, I'm trying to go underneath right there. I do manage to get one where I'm going underneath in this gameplay, but I would not recommend going for those shots. Like I said previously, I'd always recommend trying to shoot ahead and then coming in. It's definitely the much easier way to go, and you'll definitely hit a lot more shots. So, that first shot was pretty nice. I managed to get the spawn kill off there. Right now what I'm doing is planting some slam mines around the place. I always use the slam mines, I think they're a lot better than the standard mines. And I'm using the ACR, by the way. So, we're going to be staying on the Bravo MCOM. The Alpha MCOM tends to be taken by the enemy pretty quickly. And the Bravo MCOM is a lot more easier to defend, so I'd always recommend trying to stay over here. But anyway, here we go. The second shot on the straw. I'll bring it over to the left, and then I'm going to slowly drift it in and take the heli down. You notice right there, very little movement. I'd always recommend not moving your aim while the straw is in motion. You want to try and keep it in as much of a straight line as possible. Not entirely straight, of course. You're not going to be able to do that, but just don't move too much. You know, just keep it easy. Try and drift your aim, if that makes sense. Don't be so hard on the sticks, and you'll have an easier time. So, we got the transport heli coming in here. I'm going to take a shot on this one. I managed to get the hit right there, but unfortunately that's not a takedown. It usually takes 2 for the transport heli, but I do believe if you manage to shoot it inside where the passengers are sitting, I think you can get a one shot. Not too sure about that. I'll have to test that out, but I kind of think you can. So, we got these enemies pushing in here. This guy, right there, I kind of thinking, you know, I'm not going to win that gunfight, so I bail on it. That's definitely something to think about. You can't win every gunfight, especially in Battlefield 4. The connection quality isn't that great. There's a lot of lag here and there. So I'd always recommend, bailing on gunfights. If you're not getting the hits, you know, just bail on it. So anyway, we got this helicopter here. This shot right here is coming underneath. Quite a tricky thing to do. You want to try and over aim, try and keep just ahead of the heli and try and bring it in very slowly. You don't want to be too harsh on the sticks again. You just want to drift it and bring it slowly, very slowly upwards. Those shots are actually, I'd really not recommend them because they are really difficult. So once again, you know, try and just aim slightly left or right of the target and then bring it in slowly. I think that's the better option. You are going to get in situations where you're going to have to bring it upwards, but if you can avoid it, please do. You're probably going to miss anyway. They are tricky shots. So, we got the transport heli coming in here. The enemies have managed to take Alpha. Once again, it's on Gulf of Oman. I don't know about you guys on PS4 and PC and Xbox One, but in a 12v12 server, it's definitely not really worth going over there. If you have too many people over there, you'll probably lose Bravo as well. And if they manage to plant Bravo and take over the area, you're going to have a tough time defusing. So I'd always recommend staying over at Bravo. So this shot here, that was a bit of a combination of going underneath and then turning to the left. It's pretty nice shot. Once again, you know, same thing, try and keep it in a straight line. We've got the enemies pushing into Bravo here. I'm getting tagged up again. Now, this time, I'm on low health, so I just go out there and just go for it. but unfortunately I got taken out by the grenade. In that kind of situation where you're on low health, I wouldn't recommend bailing on gunfights. You might as well just go for it, because if the guy gets one or two bullets on you, you're dead anyway, so they're more than likely going to do that. But luckily in that particular situation right there, the guy was... The player thought that I was just going for cover, and you know, I just bounced straight back out, completely surprised the guy, and managed to take him out. So anyway, the sandstorm has come in now, and in this part of the video you're going to see me having a lot of trouble getting my shots on target. It is incredibly difficult to see the enemy's vehicles in these weather conditions. Transport helicopter. Okay, so we've got a lot of teammates around this area here. Looks like the enemies are coming in on the left side. You notice my teammates are quite spread out. That's always a good thing to do on this particular set of MCOM. Sorry. You know, I'm seeing a lot of players these days being too close together. I don't know what it is, but in Battlefield 4, it seems that everyone likes to you know, cram into small areas and not space out. I've said it in previous videos, but if you space out, it'll make it a lot harder for the enemy to attack you. So if you imagine you got two guys 5 foot distance between each other, you know, it's going to be an easy shot. But if there's 20 feet, 30 feet distance, it's going to be a lot harder for the enemy to switch the targets fast and get bullets down, and you've got the extra distance which will lower damage and all those good things. So anyway, we got this heli coming in here. I managed to miss it quite a lot of times. So this shot right here, I was sure it hit, but apparently it didn't. And this one right here, right underneath it, that was so close. I would not recommend hit firing the straw. I would not recommend it unless it's really close like it was there. That hit fire right there is exactly why I don't do it. It was completely off target, and the further an enemy vehicle is, the harder it is going to be for you to hit fire. So I'd always recommend ADS as much as you can. But if you're in a busy area, definitely hit fire, because you want to fire and then get straight back into the action. You don't want to be sat in a busy area looking down the scope of the straw. Definitely don't want to be doing that. So here comes the heli again. Don't ask me how that missed. If it was Battlefield 3, I think that would have hit with RPG, definitely. So the enemies are trying to push in. They're pushing in pretty hard here. I'm not sure what that guy's doing out in the open. Don't be that person. Don't fire your straw or whatever rockets out in the open. You're gonna get shot like that guy did right there. So heli is over here. I'll take another shot over there. Just missed that. Just missed that one. And I think the heli gets taken down. I think the bug of the heli being hit by a rocket and then suddenly flipping is still in the game. I think DICE may have fixed it, but I don't think they did. It's still there as far as I've seen it is anyway. That hit fire there, you know, that kind of distance is a bit, you know, don't really hit fire that distance. I got a bit lucky there, which sometimes happens. So anyway, I'm running out of things to say. Actually, I'm trying to keep this video going. I'm not the greatest at commentating. So the enemies aren't really pushing in now. There's only a couple of guys trying to get in here. We got two guys here. Shoot that guy. And we're gonna switch to single fire mode. There's a guy in the distance. Pretty hard to see on this map. If you're using a gun like the ACR at that kind of distance, you definitely want to go on single fire. The hit detection on single fire is actually amazing compared to just going fully auto or burst, I've noticed. So anyway, let's these guys pushing in once again over here. Where's that heli? Where is that heli? I know it's coming in soon. Got this guy. It looks like I think they had spawn beacons around. Here comes Heli, final shot. Nope, not that one. I missed that one. This right here, this is the final shot. This is a pretty simple shot right here. Aim slightly to the right and then bring it in slowly, following it, and then bam, get it. Once again, you know, just taking it easy with the straw. Not moving it too much, not slamming on the sticks, trying to be soft on the sticks and trying to kind of drift them, if that makes sense. You know, if you're really hard on the sticks, you might over aim, you might mess up the straw, but if you try and just be soft on them and try and, I keep saying drift, I'm not sure if that's the right word, but just be soft on the sticks, I guess. And that's pretty much the end of the game, so that was a nice little grenade there. I'm just looking around, see where the enemy is, try and get try and figure out what's going on. We've got this guy coming up here. I'm not sure where he is. There he is. Two guys down, and the game is over. So I hope you guys got something out of this video. Straw rockets, you know, just keep it simple. Don't try and over aim too much. Don't try and go underneath in all these other directions. It's more than likely gonna miss. You know, some shots you're going to have to do that, but definitely recommend trying to keep the straw as straight as you can, and coming in from the left side or the right side and trying to intercept the heli or jet, whatever it may be, on its flight path. So that's all I've got to say for today. Thank you guys for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed this gameplay. Please drop me a rating if you don't mind. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take it easy.